I can't believe because my father decided to serve Queen and country, I'm going through this.
This is the country I was born in, I was raised in, I work in. What am I supposed to do? This is the only country I know.
When I do good, I'm represented. But if I do wrong or make a mistake, no, he's not one of us. Just kick him out.
Remy, born to Nigerian parents, grew up thinking he was British, but is now fighting to not be deported.
So I remember when I first applied for my passport, and then I was told that I wasn't a citizen for some reason. They asked for my birth certificate and everything, my national insurance number. I brought them everything, my school records, sent it all off, and then I still never heard nothing back from them. Obviously, I couldn't believe it. I was very livid. I didn't feel I belonged anywhere.
He's one of hundreds of thousands of undocumented individuals born in the UK. After a change to the law in the early 80s stopped the automatic right to citizenship for children born here to non-permanent residents.
I mean, I was offered £1,300 to go back to a country I've never been. I'm born here. So they think my life is worth £1,300 that I should just jump ship.
My birth certificate.
Just like Remy, Sharon is the only one of her siblings who is not British. They were born in London, but she was born on a British Royal Air Force base in Germany, where her father was stationed as a crown servant.
What they were saying, they were treating me as if my parents went on holidays to Germany and they had me over there. Because my father, at the time I was born, he was a British subject, being born in St. Lucia. When St. Lucia became independent, my father lost his status and he reverted back to being a St. Lucian. So they said, because he went back to being a St. Lucian, I went back to being a St. Lucian as a little child. I became an illegal immigrant.
She lost her nursing job after a deportation order was issued by the Home Office.
To be not even just suspended, to be struck off, it's very difficult.
Remy, who has previous criminal convictions, found out about the deportation order while serving a 2-year sentence for drug offences.
I was due to go court in March, but because of this corona thing, it's been adjourned. So I've got to wait next year, but while I'm waiting, I'm not allowed to work. I can't claim anything, and that makes me feel even worse.
A 2007 law change meant foreign criminals who served 12 months or more face possible deportation.
In previous years, the Home Office wouldn't have sought to deport people who were born here or who were brought here as small children, but that really changed probably after the deportation scandal of 2006, 2005, 2006. This narrative developed that serious criminals couldn't be deported, and that has led to these rules that really don't allow positive discretion.
Sharon's deportation order was actually revoked while she was in prison for a separate offence. The Home Office told us she is classified as a child born abroad to parents who are not British and is on a 10-year route to settlement and is allowed to work. Leonardo, born to Filipino parents in London, was charged for being involved in a fight with a family member. Unlike Remy, he's not facing a deportation order, but he's been told he'll have to wait years to be able to even apply to fix his situation.
Because I got charged, now I have a record. I went to a few solicitors and they said to me, I have to wait 10 years and a bit maybe until I can even make the application. We never know when laws are going to change. How do I not know a year from now, 2 years from now, something will change with people who have indefinite leave to remain status?
We asked the Home Office for the status of Leonardo and Remy's cases, but didn't get a response. A naturalisation application cost over £1,000, a price many cannot afford.
Migrants are constantly being told by politicians that they should integrate and they should become citizens and so on. So to charge such a prohibitively expensive fee that we find that in practice, some people simply can't afford, or some families have to choose which children become British because they can't afford to register all of them, which is just awful. And so the parents are passing on their unlawful status basically to their children, who are then, you know, in a really difficult position for the rest of their lives.
It's just messed my whole life, and it's affected my kids. My daughter couldn't go to university because they want proof of what nationality you are. So you're just in limbo.
Why would I go and live by myself in a country on my own? What sense does that make? I will fight it because this is not right.
I can't celebrate my father being in the Air Force because presently, currently, for me, that's the worst thing that ever happened to me.